This is the first in a series of lectures entitled Marx Comes to India. The first is about Bhupendranath Dutta, who first brought the message of Marxism to Bengal and to the rest of India. Born on 4th September 1880 in Kolkata, he was first of the band of revolutionaries who, under the leadership of Aurobindo Ghosh and, as he says, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and some others, had first formed the Anushilan Samiti, which was a secret revolutionary organization. However, he participated in the Swadeshi movement in Bengal against the move of the British government to partition the state, and that is how he came to know many others. And he heard of socialism from a barrister, Athanasius Apurva Kumar Ghosh. But opportunities for learning about socialism, not to speak of communism or Marx, was extremely limited in those days. Even in the National Library, then the Imperial Library, there was only one book, and that also by Hindman, a man who betrayed the revolutionary cause during the First World War. Whatsoever, after his release from jail, when he was imprisoned because of his activities as a journalist in Juvantur, he was imprisoned for a year, and after 11 months he was released, and secretly with the help of others, he left the shores of India and landed in the USA. There he studied sociology, became an AM, that is the American degree for MA, from Brown University, and later still, he went to Germany. It was not so much a matter of academic studies, but for joining the revolutionary movement that was being recentered, relocated in Berlin during the First World War. The attempt was to organize supply of arms to India, which would ultimately lead to an insurrection here against the British rule. And during the war, the government itself would not be in a position to tackle the revolt. However, the plans didn't succeed, though the Indian Independence Committee, later known in short as Berlin Committee, was very much eager to do so, and the German government, with the help of German Indologists, had also supported them. Arms could not reach because of the British intervention. It was because of this that ultimately Bagha Jatin, Jatindranath Mukhopadhyay, died a martyr's death in Odisha. The river Budivalam, that is where they were expecting the German ship to arrive with arms. However, things moved in a different direction. When he was in Berlin, he had come to know of the Russian Revolution in 1917, and that is how he also came into touch with Marx's works, particularly the Civil War in France. This was a book that opened his eyes, and that is how he came to know about Marxism. There was the Communist International then, the Second International as it was called, and that is where he first came out with a kind of associates. He came to know certain people who were later turned out to be his associates both before and after the arrival in Germany. Manavendranath Rai had already met the beginnings of a Communist Party, although it had no more than a dozen members then in Tashkent, and he wanted the old revolutionaries to join that party. Neither Bhupendranath nor Birendra Chattopadhyay, brother of Sarojini Naidu, ever considered Manavendranath's leadership, and that's how they parted ways. And after that, Bhupendranath came back to Berlin in 1912. 20s, 21. The Berlin Committee was still there, but there has been a sharp split between the old nationalists who did not like the internationalist approach and, of course, the new internationalists with which Bhupendranath Dutta was associated. Ultimately, he decided to go back to his home in India, in Bengal, in Kolkata, and in 1925, he came back. Even before this, he had already written articles in Bengali journals sent from Berlin, in which he had urged the people to leave the romantic stories of Vande Mataram, of Bunkim Chandra's novel. We must know Karl Marx and we must cultivate mass movement. That is how he urged his people to react in the new circumstances. After coming to India, he started a concerted campaign for the communist ideology, and although he did not join the Communist Party of India, newly formed in Kanpur in 1925, December, a few months after Bhupendranath Dutta's return, he became the first person to teach Marxism to a band of young revolutionaries who were already disillusioned with the nationalist ideologies and asked for a new opening. And this is how those people who made the Communist Party a viable alternative to the nationalist tradition were all trained by Bhupendranath Dutta in his home and during his visit to the distant districts in the then undivided Bengal. The role of Bhupendranath Dutta as the first teacher of Marxism has been recognized by all. Bhavani Sen, Saroj Mukhopadhyay, Shomnath Lahiri, and many others. People who came from several mass movements, from several mass organizations, trade unions, Kishan Sabhas, students' organizations, youth organizations, they were all indebted to Bhupendranath Dutta for introducing a new light, a new opening in their own thought. And it is as a thought reformer that Bhupendranath continued to work throughout his life. He always was with the national movement, with the anti-imperialist movement, did not always agree with the Communist Party of India's stand, but never left them. During the Second World War, he was very much with the Communist Party and was one of the chief office bearers of the Friends of the Soviet Union, FSU. He had been invited to attend many conferences and many sessions of many socialist youths, and that is how he became a name with them in the 1930s and the 1940s. But Bhupendranath's achievements are not confined to what he did to the youth. He was also a trade union organizer. Before leaving the Soviet Union, he had got a letter from Lenin, who, after reading his alternative thesis, had suggested we need not think about the social classes now, gather statistical facts about the peasants' leagues if they exist in India. He took this as an order, that is how he described it, and undertook the work of gathering statistical facts. It ultimately came out in the 1950s in a book form called Dialectics of Land Economics in India. Before this, he had already written a number of Bengali books and one English book on Indian social polity. His Social History of Bengal, as written in Bangla, a 3-volume and now a 4-volume edition, has always been a source of information as well as analysis for all later Marxists. This book on the economics of land this book on the dialectics of land economics proved to be very useful, not only to the Indian Marxists, but even to the organizers of the Lenin's collected works, particularly his collected letters in the Progress Publishers and previously known as Foreign Languages Publishing House. They didn't have Lenin's draft later, so it was from Bhupendranath's printed letter that they included it in Lenin's works. In his last days, Bhupendranath was revising the work of his youth, the unpublished political history of Bengal, Aprakashito Rajnitik Itihash. He divided it into two parts, added a large number of footnotes, gave some kind of introduction to many names which would otherwise have been forgotten. He had written not only these books, he had also written his reminiscences. The English version is as yet unpublished. So a man who had, with his speeches and his pen, brought Marxism to India, mainly in the field of social history, but also economic history, and more importantly, on the study of the Vedic religion and other dialectics of ritualism. Altogether, he is the name that would always be at the top of all teachers of Marxism in India. There were other teachers in other parts of the land. Their influence was limited to their own regions. But Bhupendranath, who used to write both in Bangla and English, proved to be a man who brought Marxism to India.